Yamaka has so many microphones for beginners. How do you know which one you should really choose? Hi, Taylor here with Financial Potion, where video is your financial potion. And to never miss out on a video, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and then click on that bell so you're notified every Friday at 5 p.m. Arizona time that a new video has been uploaded. For one-to-one training or just to support our content, please click above and connect with us on our Patreon page. So we're gonna go from most expensive to least expensive option that we have here. So starting at the most expensive, we have the Yamaha CVM-WS50. And as you can see, it has a nice traveling case, which is fun. And then it also has a little tripod on here. It holds on to your phone. So this is an all-in-one system. It also is connected with just a regular audio cord. So that means you can use it on your Android phone, your iPhone. If you have that Thunderbolt cable to still have your audio connection, you can use it on your computer or tablet. So it gives you a little bit more versatility and options. At the time of its recording, this is about $160 and does a decent job for a beginner. The other option that is just $10 less would be the Boom XD. Now, as you can see, this is the box. It doesn't come with any type of nice traveling case. Maybe that saves you the $10 right there. As you can see, it's pretty small and compact, but something to keep in mind is that this particular unit is only for an Android plugin. And so if you wanted to use it with your iPhone or with your computer or an iPad, you're not gonna be able to. So you're actually a little more limited with this option. With both the lapel microphones, when I did my test, and you can see the full videos on our channel for these particular microphones, it felt like it tried to amplify the sound almost a little too much at times. Now, for only $50 at the time of this recording, we have the boom mic, so the CVM-VM10K2. And I was extremely impressed with this boom mic. Keep in mind though, it's a boom mic. And so it's going to be capturing a lot of sound and you do need to stay fairly close to it. But if you're doing a walking and talking kind of situation, or you know you're gonna be less than a foot away from the camera, you may wanna consider this boom mic. I felt actually out of all of these, it had the best sound quality, but once again, you're a little limited. You have to be close to that microphone. You can't be more than really a foot or two away from it, or else that sound quality goes down really fast. So when you're getting started with video marketing and doing your own videos, think about what your videos are going to be like. What's your setup going to be like? Are you going to be less than a foot away from your camera? Are you gonna be walking and talking? Or are you going to be 6 feet away from your camera? Knowing those details ahead of time is going to help you choose the best product for you. If you have any questions about these products, please leave them in the comments below, and I hope this helped you make a better purchase.